Let's start with the tools we're going to need out of our toolkit. So I've already gotten them out of the Bavsound toolkit. So we need our plastic panel removal tool because we will be removing this piece of wood. You might have aluminum, you might have carbon fiber. Regardless, this piece has to come out. It's really straightforward. Come back here on this back edge. Just wedge it under there like so. And kind of turn. And we just make our way around. You know, we're just prying it out like so. And once I get it started, I like to use my fingers just to pop it out. Just running my fingers along the edge, very cool, calm. There's always that one guy, you know, who back here, he didn't, had a little too much to drink. He didn't want to party. So we come back there. And we tell him, you're coming no matter what. So as you can see, it's just little tabs right out. Put this aside, I imagine this is $20,000 from the dealer. That's not true, but it's, I'm sure, preposterously expensive. Okay, so that reveals one, two Torx T25 bolts, and we have one more that secures this panel, and it's right behind the window switch. Same thing on the driver's side. We just come up here. Actually, you know what? That's just easier to use your fingers. I just put my finger under there, lift it up. You can see there's just a couple of little clips. We pop that up, unplug the window controller, and that reveals that last Torx T20. So we still got a couple more little things we want to uncover before we start. You can see behind your door handle here, there's a little round circle. Using our right angle pick, be careful here. I mean, you're not going to hurt anything at all, but you might leave a little mark. Just be conscientious when you're doing this. So you put the little tip of the hook tool between the seam here, push in, and you do that. So it pops out. That actually popped out a lot. It shouldn't have done that. It should have just popped right out and fallen into your hands, but nevertheless, it's out. And that reveals another Torx T25. And there's one more that's gonna be pretty difficult to show you guys, but it's up here in the vent that comes up, and there's another little circle pop out just like this one here. And again, we use the same methodology. We just get our hook tool in there, pop it out, and I'll show you guys. So it's back there like so. So same thing. That actually reveals a Phillips head screw, interestingly enough. Why they did that? Maybe they ran out of Torx bits. I don't know. So let's go ahead and pop this Phillips head bit out back here, and then we'll take the other four screws out, and then this panel comes right off. So it's really straightforward. You really wouldn't think a $100,000+ car would come apart this easily, but like all BMWs, completely over-engineered. Actually, those are T20s, my bad. We've had a bunch of cars in here today, I can't remember. So your sixer has T20s. One, two, and again, go answer some emails, make some phone calls. You probably don't want to watch me unscrew a bunch of screws, so super exciting. So remember, the silver screws go up high, the short silver screws go on the upper part, and the door handle and the longer black screws go here in the armrest portion, because this is where the bulk of the panel's mass is located. So you can see these longer screws go in the bottom. So remember that. That is especially relevant when you're reassembling this. And they put them in there, so when you put it back together, don't be afraid. Really working them. Just kidding. Just be conscientious of it. All right, so with those guys out, we now have all five screws out of the door. Last little thing we're gonna do before we take the door itself off is, there's a little light down here, and we're gonna take our plastic panel removal tool. It's kind of, you guys can see it. We're just gonna pry it under the light. The light pops right out. You can see I just depressed this little tab, it pops right out, and we unplug the light like so. So that leaves the door ready to come off. And the door is secured by a series of clips around the perimeter and then across this top. And that's how the rest of the panel is secured. So these are big, heavy door panels. And the primary reason for that is that there is an airbag attached to the panel that we're going to remove. Don't let it scare you. We simply remove it. Take a wire tie. You just, we'll go over all this. Wire tie the airbag module up onto another little harness while we take the door over to our space and work. So let's get started. It's not complex at all. Actually, with this screw out up here, it leaves this top edge of the door loose already. So one of the things you can do is a plastic panel removal tool. Do not use metal on these leather wrapped doors. You will have some very nice little scratch marks on your door if you do that. So we'll get back here. I kind of come back here. This one's tight. That's good though. Let's see. So we get it freed. Once I get one done, boy, I tell you, they build these sixers really well. I guess they should. I've spent so much money on them. So again, we're just using this to free the panel. And I'm gonna just show you guys the traditional route instead of the way I tend to do it. Sometimes little clips pop out. You can, so this way you can actually see what we're doing. We'll just snap it right back in. So all we're doing is just freeing these little clips from the perimeter. You can see I'm just using my hands. And now the whole door is free except for this top edge, which is where we're gonna come next. And so there's metal clips that are attached to this window trim here that we need to get the door off of. So it's always a little fun. They're always, always, always tight. There we go. So then you see the lock here. So we wanna lift up off of that lock. See that comes off. So that's all we're unhooking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clips there. And we now, as you can see, you see an airbag here. So we've got some plugs to unplug. First of all, we've got our LED plug right here. Be very careful with this. We just depress in, unplug like so, and we are free. We've got this thing, which who really knows what that does, but we unplug it. Now we take our metal panel removal tool out of our toolkit because we need to undo some little clips back here. And again, mind you, if this really doesn't take more than 5 minutes to get this whole panel off. It's really not that complex. So we're just disconnecting a couple things. Look at that. Airbag is all rusty. This is a pretty darn new car too. So now we unplug, do this clip here, like so. And this is kind of, I wouldn't say it's tricky, but this clip that goes inside of the window housing, check this out. You can see it in here. There's a little tab. This is the plug on the inside. So we just lift up on this tab right here. It's really hard to do this when you're having to try and make it visible for photography. Boy howdy. Why don't we try it from just coming from back here the good old fashioned way. There we go. So it just pops out, just that little ball holds it in. Just another little light for the door, so we're being very careful with that. So that is unplugged, and now the magical airbag removal, which again, it's not that bad. Our Torx T20, I think that's actually a 25. We can use a 20. So we take our 25 Torx, so. me unscrew this airbag. Again, just don't be a moron when you're messing around with this. Don't drop it. Don't throw it. Don't have a friend back at the battery trying to spark the battery terminals together, explode it on you. It wouldn't hurt. It would just be uncomfortable. Especially if you had the panel up about a foot and a half more this way. All right. So we're going to show you the... So, we got the airbag unhooked. Now we just grab our wire tie, lift out the airbag, just run a little wire tie through it, tie it up here out of our way. Airbag's fine, like so. So we've got our harnesses unplugged. Now the last thing we need to do is disconnect our door handle. And you can see kind of it's up in here. Just kind of like route it out of there. And we just lift up like so out. You can actually see over here, you wanna, that's how it's the proper alignment is. So we've got it hooked, it comes out here and then it comes out and around and then ultimately back to the door. But so that's it. So we've got our door panel completely free. And at this point, we're gonna pause. We're gonna take this up to our workbench. We'll join you guys there for the mid-base installation. And then we're also gonna do, we'll get this tweeter pod off as well. We're here in the workspace, our 6-series door panel. We're gonna get the speaker off, the factory mid. We're gonna get this thingamabob off. And we're gonna apply sound deadening in this general vicinity because there's a lot of plastic resonance going on back here and we wanna calm all of that down. So, the drivers are held on with Phillips heads. So we'll just, using our drivers, our screwdriver from the Bavsound kit, just pop this guy out. So, this is exciting stuff, huh? So say bye-bye to the harsh mid-range you've been enduring for years. And now we'll get this device off. I never bothered to figure out what it was. Didn't really affect us or our development, so. But you might know, or I bet there's a guy on the internet that knows. Those guys know everything on the internet. All right, so that's out of the way. So that leaves us with our area here that we need to deaden. So the way we like to do it is we take our sound deadening that we've sent you. We're gonna kind of cut off about this much. I have some scissors. And then what I do is I kind of start cutting it into pieces. This can just be a, you know, we can actually, this can be applied to any of our cars. This is, the key with sound deadening is just getting the material focused around the mid-range driver to control the resonance of the panel in that vicinity. So, that being said, what we'll do here, is you can see how this panel is basically plastic welded to this panel with these little pieces here. So what I'll do, I'll just cut a little piece right here. There's no real wrong way to do this. I mean, there are, again, guys on the internet that know better, but after 20 years, we figured out what does and doesn't work and why you do things certain ways. And with sound deadening, it's really, the key is coverage around the driver itself. So again, we get the sound deadening applied down like that. I've got a little razor blade here. Sometimes, you know, you just make little slits in it. You can do a little bit better with getting it applied a little bit tighter maybe or whatever like that. So again, the key is to kill the plastic. So we do the same thing above the speaker to the side of the speaker. So let's kind of look at this. Let's kind of do, again, we're just eyeballing stuff here. This isn't rocket scientists, and you, however you're doing this, you're not doing it wrong. So just know that. So we want to come in a little bit more even with that. And I'm just eyeballing stuff here. I do that. And then we want to kind of come. So we get that done. Kind of clip a little bit here. Clip a little bit there. And again, you can just do this however you want. This is just a, sorry, I know I'm making this difficult for our cameraman. Right, so you can see this kind of be like that. And then what I'll do is cut off all of this. So we'll peel off the adhesive. It's best if you've got a hair gun or a heat dryer, geez Louise, a heat gun or a hair dryer. I don't have one with me here today, but it's pretty darn warm here. So this stuff's already nice and tacky. But if you're doing this in the dead of winter in the middle of Wisconsin, you absolutely wanna make sure you get this nice and tacky. Again, I'm just using the base of this to, you can see how it kind of forms all to the edges of the panel, like so. Gets it nice and adhered. So again, we've got the nice and controlled there. Then you just got, you have your little pieces. And again, you can't mess this up. So we've got a little piece here. You might as well put it right under here where the little mystery piece resides. Again, to keep that from resonating on the plastic, because the speaker is going to be creating a lot of energy in this area. So again, we'll do that there. We'll take another piece. And remember, there's actually a door screw that goes right there, so you don't really want to cover that up. So what we'll do is we'll come starting up here, and we'll come all the way down to the speaker. And it's fun stuff, you know. This is just, it takes us back to being 6 years old and playing with construction paper, right? So we'll do that. I'll cut this off a little bit. And just keep in mind, this is aluminum on the front of this, so it is kind of sharp. Don't cut your fingers off. That is our pro tip of the day. Don't cut your finger off. As you can see, again, all this stuff, it's so nicely. And then we come around like so. And this is the same methodology on all the cars. So E36, E46, E39, E92, all of the cars. Hell, even if you don't have a BMW, these general principles are the same. As you can see, so now, got a nice dead panel as opposed to what we had before. So let's do a little bit more, only because we've sent you 6 feet of this stuff, so we might as well use it all, or use as much of it as we can. So we just don't obviously want to mess with this airbag area. So take this other big piece, you know, keep in mind there's the holes, so we don't want to cover those up. So why not? We've got all this plastic back here. Let's cover it up. So this is, and this helps a little bit with road noise. I mean, our cars are already pretty quiet, except those of you that have aftermarket exhausts and such. For the rest of us, cars are pretty darn quiet. So again, we're just getting all this down like so. Pretty cool, you can see all the little areas get formed down in there. Pretty cool. All right, so I'm gonna do a little bit right here only because this is a known area to rattle, and plus the three panels are joined right here. So I'm gonna bring this piece across like so. And again, there's gonna be people that are, that's not how you sound dead and nubbin. Hey man, whatever. Trust me, this is all you need to be doing. Again, there's no fine art to this or whatever. You could have your 8-year-old come out and give you a hand if you wanted. He or she might enjoy that, actually. So I'm just putting little slits to help get it down there a little bit better. Like so. See, I've got a little bit, another little skinny piece here. And again, this is just kind of redundant. You can fast forward through a lot of this because most of this you will just do on your own. There's no sense in watching me go to these lengths to get this on here. So again, that's kind of the way we're gonna do this. And you know, this is, actually, you know what? I'm gonna put a big piece right here because we have plenty, and that's still reasonably close to our driver. So again, especially in the convertibles, there's not a lot of space in the back for sound deadening. So we might as well just use as much as we can up here in the front. And you can do the whole door. I mean, we send you 6 feet of this stuff. So You can put 3 feet in each door panel if that is what you would like to do and you want to take the time to do that. It is not going to hurt anything. It's just going to make everything a little bit more quiet, and we're going to control the movement of these panels and the energy of the speakers. So again, look at that. So now we got this whole So now it's nicer instead of a clink, clink, clink. So this is fantastic. We've got some really good coverage here. Let's see, I think I have another, there's a little piece you found here. So the best place is on the junction of panels because it keeps them quiet. They're at that junction. So, brilliant. Got our old driver here. Here's the new Bavsound driver. Woven fiberglass, curvilinear cones, inverted surrounds. Beautiful drivers. We're replacing directly our factory speaker. So again, this drops on just like the factory speaker did, exactly the same way. There's no slots in the speaker. This isn't some random half generic speaker. It's tailored specifically to this car. So the holes line up perfectly. Just get them started, get everything a little started, and then we'll go back and snug everything up. And then I'll show you guys another little trick. I just do this because it's kind of the way BMW does it. Plus, we leave these wires a little long just for posterity's sake. So I take a little bit of, you can use black duct tape, or this is gaffer's tape. We're here in Los Angeles, so all these camera guys have all this fancy tape. I just bring this up here like so. Bring the wires down here on the side, tape them just nice and out of the way, and leave them up here so that when we plug in our tweeter, which is going to come from up top, it's very easy to do so. So again, just a little cleanliness now goes a long way later. There we go. So excellent. So the mid-range is now waiting for the tweeter. So let's do this. Let's put the door panel up right here out of the way. You guys can kind of see what we're doing. So here's the factory tweeter. As you can see, the factory tweeter, it's got a little bit of motion in there. It's already, all we're gonna do is pry it out. So we've got these little tabs here. So let's just basically take our little angle tool. Let's take a couple little pries. It'll come out of there like so. Cool. So the factory tweeter pops out. No more ear searing aluminum domed tweeter gnarling your ears. We have a beautiful silk composite, snaps right in just like the factory tweeter. This is such a tight, perfect fit that sometimes it takes 2 seconds, you know, it takes a minute to get it in there, but it's an absolutely perfect fit. So as you can see, it snaps right in there and it's tighter than the factory. Now you can see the beautiful aluminum outer ring. It's a perfect match in there. So the tweeter snaps in, we take this foam, put it right back in place like it was from the factory. Voila, we're done. So let's pause it here. We're gonna get back over to the door, reinstall the front door, then we're gonna head up to the center channel, knock that out, head to the back, wrap it up, and get the party started. All right, ladies and gents, here we are in the back seat of our E63 coupe. You might notice that we've already done the front speakers, we've done the center channel, and you'll notice that was done in a red convertible, and that is in fact true. Same car, front doors, center channel are the same between the two coupes and convertibles. Obviously the rear is in fact different, so we're gonna tackle that now. It's very simple, the bottom cushion has to come out, the back cushion has to come out, which will give us access to the rear deck. And then we've got the mid-range and the tweeter in each rear side panel that we need to address. So let's get started. Super simple. Just quite frankly, just lift up on the bottom cushion of the back seat, like so. Then we pop out this center piece here. Get it out of the way. Let's put it up here on the rear deck for right now. The bottom cushion comes out, just lifts right out of the car. There's a 10 millimeter nut under here on each side. Pretty cool. So that just pops right off. There's one on either side. It's silver. One of the funny things you have to do is rock each one of these headrests out. They're in there really good. So you actually have to rock them out. There's no... So you can feel it coming down side by side. And then it just lifts out. Do that on both sides. You can now kind of just take this and get it out of our way, because we do need to gain access to these rear side panels. So that being said, this is one of those things where it really is a lot easier. This does not come in our toolkit. If you've got a Torx T55, it's a hell of a lot easier to pull this seat belt out of here and fold it through here, and because we need this seat cushion out of the way. Otherwise, it's just really tough to work back here. It's tight. So I'm gonna pull the bottom of these seat belt brackets out. Again, you can't miss them. They're back here on the floor. If you don't have that, you can still make this happen. It's just a lot more, it's a lot tighter back here. So we need the space to show you guys. So I'm gonna get it out. We're gonna pause here, come back and get the party started.
Like I'd mentioned, we loosened the seatbelt bottoms. You don't need to pull it all the way through. And quite frankly, in retrospect, you don't necessarily need to take this out. It just makes it a little bit easier. Effectively, we've got to work the seat out of our way because we have to get off both side panels. And again, this is a very simple process. As you saw, this just took a couple of minutes. I mean, a minute to get out. This panel comes off in a minute. So let's talk about how we do that. There's a little piece right here. It's going to be wood grain, aluminum, black. It's going to be various colors. It's just got three little pins in it. And I just use my fingers and pry it off. And if your fingers aren't strong enough, you can use your plastic panel removal tool and just, I've already got it out just because in the interest of time. So this just pops right out, and that's gonna reveal a Torx T20 right up here. And there's only two screws that hold this whole panel on, and then it just pops right out. So it's really straightforward. I mean, the truth of the matter is, I mean, this is one of the easier cars to do. It doesn't seem like it necessarily, but it really is. Plus, you can get back in here and get all the crap out and clean all the... You can see where the armor all line stopped. You can fix all that. Basically, just get the car a nice wipe down. Get those guys out. Now, with these two screws out of the way, we need to take off this seat belt piece that covers... I'm trying to pull this out. It'll come out eventually. Anyway, so this panel here snaps right out. Boy, oh boy. Come up here. Get this back. There we go. And then we can come down here, and then these just pop right off. So you can see these actually stayed in. So what we'll do is we'll just pop them out. Pop them out. And then we'll just snap them right back into place. With that out of the way, we now have access to this panel. So what we're doing, there's a little clip here, and a clip here. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna come out, and then we're gonna come up. And all right, so we just take our hands, pull, pull. Just got a couple of plastic clips back here. That's all it is. You're not gonna hurt anything. Look at that, it just comes right out. As I mentioned, we just unplugged the speaker, unplugged this little module back here. So if you guys head on over to my side, I'll show you, we just unplugged the speaker here, and then we come down here to this little module, and we unplug that as well. And now we can take the panel out and over to our workspace. We are now on our workbench. We're gonna pull off our mid-range and install our new tweeter in the process. So, this is not complicated. So again, you know, it's a couple minutes to get the back seat out, a couple minutes to get the panel out. I mean, realistically, this is for someone that's never done this before. It's a half hour process. That's not true. 45 minutes if you've never done it. An hour if you've been drinking. And again, I don't judge. I'm not saying I haven't had a beer today. Although I haven't. It's too damn hot. But all right. So we unplug the tweeter, pop off this brutal mid-range, put in our beautiful new mid-range. And now we drop the new Bavsound mid-range into the same location, and we adhere it using the same
screws that we use to fix the factory driver to it. So just so you're kind of clear, I'm doing a voiceover right now. If it sounds like I'm sitting at a desk with a glass of Cavathier with the lady, it's because I am. That's not true. I don't have ladies or Cavathier here. So we're just doing a little voiceover. We lost the audio the day we were filming, and so now we are just going back. So again, just reattach the mid-range as you removed it. It's not super complex. Fortunately, we've gone to great lengths to make it easy. And now, unscrew the ring on the back of the tweeter counterclockwise, pop the tweeter out the front of the panel. Boop. And I don't know what in the hell I'm talking about here. I'm just rambling about nothing, probably. Blah, blah, blah. Most likely that. I can't imagine what else I would be saying. Hey, look, it's a silver tweeter. The good news is we're taking these horrible metal tweeters out of the equation and putting in some fantastically smooth silk tweets. I don't know what I could still be talking about. I think I might be talking about how you extract this plastic panel off the back of the tweeter housing. So we're going to grab our metal panel removal tool, and you can see the three openings where the terminals for the tweeter are, and then the other more square opening where the wires go into the housing. So basically we're popping off this little plastic cap with the orange sticker on it, and then the tweeter itself is affixed to the ring using a little bit of glue from BMW. So we're just going to pry this ring out, which combination of our metal panel removal tool and our the right angle pick tool. And again, both of these are in the Bavsound toolkit, which you absolutely want to order with this car. And now I'm just kind of going through, stabbing myself in the palm with the right angle pick. Also, be careful, because this will absolutely impale you. So you see, with that out, we now have access to the tweeter, and we can just carefully pry it out of there using our angle pick. Just kind of work your way around it. Da-da-da-da-da. Still prying. I probably said a curse word there. There it goes. Look at that. Just prying it out of there. Then our new tweeter snaps right in. Depending on when you're watching this, you're going to want to make sure if the little harness, the little heat shrinked harness isn't there, there will be a separate harness you will need to install between the mid-range and the tweeter to protect the tweeter. So with the new tweeter in there, it's a perfect fit, but we're very anal about things, and so we just put a couple little dabs of the included E6000 adhesive. It's an automotive engine adhesive, so it's super strong and designed for the wild heat swings and humidity and temperature swings, etc. So just get it situated back in the panel, drop our ring, which I'm guessing here I probably said I lost the ring. Where the hell did the ring go? I'm looking for it. Oh, there it is. And then you screw it back on, and you plug the tweeter into the mid-range, and let's see, look at that, nice and snug. And you plug the tweet into the mid-range, and you hide this under the foam, like so. So you just snap the capacitor into the same little housing that the factory one came out of, and then basically you just put it all together. Like so. Nothing complex. You just want to leave the cable out. Having a little bit longer cable on the back makes it a hell of a lot easier when we're putting everything back together. So we just left a nice little lead on there to make that process easier for you guys, as you can see. So that panel's done. And at this point, we would just, I can't imagine what I'm rattling on about. It goes back over to the car, and we reinstall it the exact same way we removed it. We're ready to put the panel back in. It of course goes in the exact same way it came out, which is we want to hook this little, remember, we want to hook this little front edge first, like so. So we get that hooked. Obviously it's going to be a little bit harder for me to be out of the way at this point, so you guys are just going to have to kind of watch and infer here and there. So get some things situated. All right, so you line up the little, just eyeball these little front clips on this front edge, like so. And just, let's see, look at that. We kind of, we got a little party pooper right now. Who doesn't want to play?
There we go. So that all snaps right back in. Got a little snap down here, snap, snap, snap. And we still have our screw here, screw here. You see, it goes back together brilliantly. Then we just take our, I'm sure there's a little wonkiness here. We take this, and again, don't rush this. Just take 2 extra seconds. You'll feel the little tabs, the little plastic tabs, snap, like right now, so that's not lined up. So you look up, see what the hell is going on, move the little clip into place, still acting up. There we go. So just watch this edge of the foam here. Then we just knock the foam right back into place. I mean, the cars are built so unbelievably well, and at this point we just, I mean, there's no sense in watching. At this point we just put the little screws back in. I can't really see. Put both screws back in. Top, bottom, and then the back seat just slots right back in. I like to put the bottom cushion in before I move up and do the rear deck speakers, only because it's easier to sit. So why don't we do that? There's no sense in watching this. I mean, we're just gonna actually, you know what? Let's do this real quick. We might as well. You're committed at this point. The camera's a little wonky, I'm sure, over there. Sorry, guys, but you know, if you're driving this car, you've clearly got a brain. I should hope. If you don't have a brain and you're driving this car, I'd like to know your secret. All right, so then we just freaking, you know, hook that back up there like so. There's a little.
Yeah, I can't see shit right now.
Yeah, no, it's just, it's hard to show you guys this. It really is. So the back seat, you know, just freaking goes right back like so. And then the back seat just sits right back up in there like it always did. And now, let me show you how to pop in that bottom seat. First, actually, you guys can probably go ahead and check this out. Go ahead and put the seat belt back in, because that's gonna come in handy. So again, for those of you that might have taken out this Torx T55, it's obviously on a 3/8 inch drive. I've got it on a big snap-on thing. Again, you don't have to do this. It makes it marginally easier, and quite frankly, I didn't even do it on the other side, so it's showing you the two options. So, and then we, remember, we put our 10 millimeter nuts back on here. Let's secure the bottom of the seat. And if anyone has any suggestions on what to do about my thinning hair, you can email me at jws@bavsound.com. I really don't want to have to get a toupee, but I might, man. I might get something really sweet. I don't know. If you've got a toupee and it's awesome, send me some pictures. Not creepy stuff, though. All right. So, let's get the back seat back in. I'm only sort of half kidding about that. Actually, I'm not kidding about it. My wife gets hit by a bus, I gotta be ready. Get back out in the market. You know how it goes. All right, so we'll pop the back seat back in. So. And, so we need these out to get to the back seat. That's right. It's a weird setup. Okay, so. This is actually gonna be pretty tough to show you guys, but getting it out is the easy part. Using our plastic panel removal tool, we've just like up on the center channel, we just pry it out. Be careful.
Stay right there, let me get a different angle. I can't see shit, so.
You wanna come in here and get dirt? That's not gonna work, does it? It's tinted. Here, come up in here, man. It's easy enough. It smells a little bit like dude. Yeah.
Still rolling.
Okay.
Yeah, you're good.
All right, so we are all up in here. So, quite frankly, I'm not going to subject you or my camera guys to this. So once we get this guy free, again, just using our fingers and plastic panel removal tool. What I like to do, you have 1, 2, 3, 4 Phillips head screws. We send in our toolkit, we've got the right angle Phillips driver, so you pull this thing out, and the whole little housing comes out, and then the speaker attaches. So we're gonna pull the housing out, it's really simple. Right angle tool, I'm sure my hand is in the way. And again, just breaking free. It's kind of crazy, this is a, you know, those of you guys with an M6, you know, it's $150,000+ car, and you can take it apart in minutes. And it's rewarding, you know, like you get up in here and you're like, some dude spent 5 years designing this car and you figured it out in 20 minutes. Furthermore, I hate paying people to do things that I know how to do or can learn how to do. I'm gonna have to do something to get this Eddie Murphy song out of my head. I don't know. I don't think we have any beers at the facility. Although I'm afraid it would get worse. All right, so that frees up our whole little pod here. It just pops right out of the deck like so. We unplug the speaker. We take the whole pod out. We'll take it up to the workspace. It's self-explanatory. I mean, we'll show you. This is, we're showing you this because I can't tell you, but it's obviously we pull out this speaker, put in our driver in its place. So it's a Torx T20. Pop this guy out of his little pod. This is also the same for the E65 7 Series. Those of you, E65, E66 7 Series. This is the same. Out with the old. In with the new. It's really nothing to it, as you can see. And then obviously we take this back over to the car and reattach it, which we are not covering that process. I'm just gonna assume that you can pull that off. So don't wrench one down in particular, just get them all kind of started. Get it started, kind of start snugging it up, because we've got a nice foam ring on the bottom side that's sealing up in there, so snug them. So, and voila, installed. So we're just reattaching the driver back here. Take our grill, snap it back in. Be careful with that. Now we grab our headrests, which we have inconveniently placed in the front seat. Remember, these actually secure the top of the seat in place. So. Make sure you do this right, like so. So the seat is now in place. The headrests just snap right back in. Voila. Like so, get our tools out of the way. We take our pod, we snap it in. And look at that. Rear sound stage should take you about an hour, start to finish, to upgrade all 6 rear speakers. It's really straightforward, brilliant. The sound is obviously night and day. I don't know that it, but it, and not to mention, look how beautiful the tweets are buried in there. These beautiful polished aluminum rings just glowing. So that's about it for the rear soundstage, guys. So at this point, we're gonna head back up to the front, go over some tuning.
So let's hop into our settings here. This is kind of, and again, I've been doing this so long, and all of our ears are different. I acknowledge that, but basically the key is we want bass and treble flat in the Logic 7 cars. And then we want to go into our, you can turn your Logic 7 surround on. I think it's horrible. I think it really colors the sound and does a lot of bad things to the music. So I turn it off, and then I go into my EQ. You know, there's no need in these cars to artificially boost 100, 200 hertz, because the woofers in here They just, even upgraded woofers, you're not going to create any more output. We're limited, so we don't want to distort anything, so let's leave it flat. 500K is getting into our mid-range, lower mid-range, kind of mid-bass even. So that can get a little peaky, so you know, flat, maybe plus one. It really depends. I still would leave mine flat. This 1 and 2K, that's straight up mid-range, so if you are driving with the top down, maybe bump that a little bit. Again, I like to leave it flat. That's just how I always listen. The 2K, we're starting to get into some of our tweeters' responsibilities on the lower end of things. So again, we want to be careful with that. So let's keep that maybe flat or plus one again. 5K, you can do whatever you want with. Those of you that are a little older, probably might go a little bit higher. And then with 10K, if you're over 50, you don't hear that anyway. So you can do whatever you want with that. But again, maybe just, that's where you can pretty much leave that flat, maybe plus one, two. But again, you kind of want your EQ largely flat. Anywhere from 2K and up, you can tweak it to your personal, you know, to your ear. But 1K and down, flat, maybe one notch up. Otherwise, we're just distorting the preamp signal. So let's leave everything pretty much flat. This is how we maximize the sound in the car. This is how we make sure we get a balanced, neutral sound that's going to last a lifetime. It's not going to fatigue our ears. It's going to enhance the drive and let us rock on from now on. All right, this battery has about had it in this M6, so I'm going to fire the car up. And on that note, guys, we are gonna sign off and see you guys on the next round. Thanks so much for stopping by.